Hey, good morning. Because I am doing this a little earlier, it looks like the storms have passed and I could turn on my computer. I don't do that when there's lightning and thunder and stuff around the place. Learned the hard way many years ago, so I just don't risk it even with the modern stuff and technology, especially probably. So we're here on Tuesday, Wednesday, the 11th of November, Remembrance Day here in Australia. And we're getting organised. Well, I'm doing, I am organised, doing the daily live stream Lenormand card spread. G'day, Eva, over on Periscope. Wonderful to see you from there. And Stevie, all the way in the UK. Wonderful. You're heading towards your evening, aren't you? So I am going to get into doing the reading pretty quickly because I actually have another place to be and I'm supposed to be on the road by 8. So attempting that now. We'll switch over to the card spread. Good morning, Rena. Hopefully I'm getting the right screen. I have, and there's the cards. I forgot to line up the camera. As you can tell, it's a bit of a spooky-ish light this morning because of the weather out there. Good morning, Tracy. Good morning, Shaz. Yeah, I put it in the comments on the My Time event page, Shaz, that I was going to be going early this morning, heading up to babysit shortly. Gilded Reverie Lenormand deck is the one that I'm still using, as Ciro Marchetti's artwork is so superb, so I love it, and that's why I'm using it. So thank you for fitting today's in safely. Well, yeah, it would have been a message saying I couldn't do it if there was raging lightning and thunder at the moment. I think it's calmed down enough that I can safely keep the computer going for now. That's what I'm hoping anyway. I'm going to just move that over a little bit because I need it more centered, and it wasn't. So you've got to see the back of my hand, which is fine. It's just a getting old lady-ish, as you can tell. But that's what life is, isn't it? Moving through our ages and stages. Yes, still a few familiar cards from yesterday, especially. What we have is the home, no, workspace. The books are in the workspace, which we've had recently as well. They were in the home space yesterday, and the day before it was workspace. So it's a repeating pattern. So workspace. Here we have the home space. Up the top, we've got the clouds in the unexpected with the lightning storms and the rest. Cross in your role, and we've got the home or house in the outcome. So, and I forgot to mention that is the moon in the home energy. So it's all really good. We've got Judy just joined as well. So g'day to you too, Judy, or good morning. Right, books in that workspace. Oh God, my hair. I washed it and now I can't do a thing with it. It's in the face. I was going to put my hairband on, but I wanted it to dry properly. books in the workspace. Yep, it's hitting those books again, getting those things written if you're doing courses and all that sorts of stuff. So it really is delving into that. I suppose it's a bit of the deeper end of it because, I mean, to read and write, we need to use a bit more of that, you know, what is our cerebral functions, and eyesight to read, as you know, as far as glasses goes, I need mine to do that. But it's putting all of what you can into that learning, the even writing, if you're an author and want to write courses or things like that, teacher, all sorts of ways that we use books in our daily lives, and most especially in business space or workspace. It doesn't matter that a lot of them are online onto technology in the clouds now, and we don't usually physically use the actual book and paper and that as much anymore, but we still do. We still, I do. So pick them up, write into, and etc. It's all of those different realms for using our books today in that workspace, job space. Moving over to the moon in our home space, that's bringing up the reflections. Oh, good morning, Carol. How are you? Lovely flowers in the emojis there. Bringing forward what is that more nurturing energy and the light of the moon. It is a more feminine feeling in this energy, because of the moonlight, it is recognized as the feminine and nurturing and actually bringing out from the shadows what needs to be looked at a bit more in depth. That can be in your relationships. It can actually be in what you see in the physical as well. You know how the light hits it in a different way. So it might be that you're needing to change perspective. And that also things that seem to be happening in cycles and repeating. Ha ha ha. Here we've got the box and the cross there. That's definitely been a repeater. And the clouds. Yeah, familiar cards, familiar patterns. So look at why the patterns are happening. Is there something that you actually need to change so that you're getting a different result and creating a new pattern in your life? And this is the home space. Remember those things that are to do with family, home, friends, all of that that's closer to you. Okay. We've got in the unexpected is the clouds, certainly reflective of what yesterday afternoon into the night and through to this morning. It really was spectacular lightning displays and the thunder, the noise, the rain, downpours we had here. It's been expressed in very much in a real sense with this card, the cloud card. So it's clearing now, but it's still going to be that unexpected shadow side happening in our life, whether that's on our emotional level or even the physical. The stormy stuff may not have passed fully yet. It could be still going to revisit through the day. That's why it's in the unexpected position. And it could also be that things might be for you happening in that way that is like it's the clouds and the stormy weather, you know, emotionally, physically being exhausted and really just wanting to hunker down. It could be all of those things or none. It just could be just that freshening rain moving through, like we're experiencing all the storms, because it certainly has freshened the grasses and the ground out there as I'm looking out my window. And now we've got the cross that's actually in our role, that space. It was in the workspace yesterday because I can remember saying, look, that what used to be a business I helped build is now dead. It's my role to continue finishing that process of letting go of all of those ties that were connected with that. So there could be something that you had that's a residue from the yesterday's position of the cross into today's being your role. So continue working through that process that's going to move it to being released. Let it go. And that's definitely what I'm feeling very strongly with that today. So allow it. Give yourself permission to let it go. Some of the responsibilities we feel that is our duty over the years aren't any longer. Let it go. And it will either in due process die a death that is needed for that next step to grow and flourish and germinate, actually, or it will just be someone else's responsibility that you've held for too long that needs to be taken up elsewhere. Whichever form that is, it's your role to let it go. That's what I'm feeling really strongly, let it go. And that's message to self as well. And now we move to the home that is the outcome. And it's going to bring that beautiful peace, tranquility and welcoming aspect of I'm feeling I'm at home in all the energies that we've got around us today. And it's that nice, safe, secure space and place, especially in the storm, that we can make it. We need to decide we are making our home that safe and secure space and place. Look, even if you don't physically live in a safe place, because I know that there's some people that don't, that even in our own bodies, our own hearts, that we can create that space for ourselves. And that is going to be our outcome today, because it's the decision we've made that we are creating that through all avenues of who we are. Okay, so I'm feeling it really is letting that breath out and relaxing and being in that space, the inner and the outer. Okay, so on that note, I am going to leave it there because I do need to pronto get going, finish my cup of coffee, have a very quick bite to eat and hop in the car. So thank you very much for being part of my morning this morning, even if early, to be able to share with you what is possibly a little bit of guidance using the tools of the cards to help you clarify your direction in life or an understanding, or even just to learn a little bit smidgen more about you and who you are to continue being that best you that you can be. So thank you again. I'll see you tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. And namaste until then. Bye for now.